Welcome back to Behind the Lines. I'm Graham Knight. Over the course of the next couple of weeks, the Behind the Lines team will be doing a deep dive into the history and techniques of option football, something often referred to as a ballet. The Academy Football Report had the good fortune to catch up with former Navy head coach Paul Johnson. Diane Roberts starts off our series of conversations with Coach Johnson, and her interview was a reunion of sorts between coach and reporter. Here's Diane.
My first year in Washington, D.C., covering sports and covering Navy, you were the head coach. So it's nice to see you again. We both have been around a little bit. For people who don't know, Coach, can you tell us what the triple option offense is?
Well, the triple option is actually one play, but it's designed that it has any of three ball carriers can have the ball, and it's based after the snap off reads. There's an initial read. You leave two guys unblocked, one to play the dive and one to take the quarterback, and then you have numbers that and angles that hopefully can outnumber the defense if you can do the thing right and read the thing right on the way out. So the guy doesn't take the fullback or the B back. You hand him the ball. If he does, then the quarterback goes to the second option. If the guy takes him, he pitches. If he doesn't, then he runs the ball. And there can be variations. There's all kinds of variations off it, and you can change the blocking schemes. But it's basically just one play in the offense.
Why is it effective for service academies? Because service academies, they can't compete with the Alabamas and the Floridas and the Georgias. Right. They have to be different. Is that why the triple option works for them?
The thing about the academies, the recruiting's different. And the one thing I learned after leaving Navy and going to Georgia Tech, you know, in a typical year at Navy, we probably signed 70 or 80 guys, counting direct in the prep school. And at those other schools, you're limited. Probably the most we ever signed at Tech in a year was 24. So you might not be getting the guys that are, you know, graded as high by the recruiting sites or whatever, but you're also getting a lot of guys in that 80 that are diamonds in the rough that they missed on. So it gives you a chance to be competitive.
Who introduced you to the triple option?
Well, a long time ago, we actually ran the stuff when I was in high school. Playing, we're a wishbone team. And then when I started coaching, when I got out of college, I went back to my high school and was fortunate enough to be the offensive coordinator right back out of college. And then after that, I went to a junior college and got away from it. We were more a I-formation team back then. I left there and went to Georgia Southern as a defensive coach. We were a combination kind of run and shoot, a little bit of option at Georgia Southern while I was coaching defense. And when I moved over to the offensive side of the ball, we just kind of evolved into what we did pretty much my whole career. I think the academies, because it's hard to find the fast receivers and the guys that can do that, you don't maybe throw it as much. Georgia Southern, we could do whatever we wanted. We had some really good teams, and we went 62-10 while we were there. And, so we didn't throw it as much because we were usually ahead in the games and didn't have to. But, over my whole career, somebody did a study a few years ago, and through about 30-some years of doing it, we had averaged about 34, 35 points a game and well over 400 yards. So it had been successful pretty much everywhere we coached. Hopefully there's enough people that still understand it and know how to do it that it'll be around. But, you know, football goes in circles. What was popular once goes away, that people, you know, think they figured out a way to play it. And then all of a sudden it comes back in a different form or whatever. So I think it'll be around for a long, long time. Option football for sure.
Next week, when we continue our conversation with Coach Johnson, we'll discuss his coaching tree, a tree that includes Coach Ken Niumatalolo, Coach Jasper, and Coach Jeff Munkin.